out of the whole experience, what do you think was the best thing for you? Like,
I don't know, I like to say the friendships that I made, because the geeks are all just a bunch of great guys, really. They're really fantastic. I'm hoping that I'll stay in touch with them long after the show's over, and the beauties are all incredible. It was a great experience being in a house with so many people who you could get along with, because I was expecting a lot of, you know, stuff to go down, and maybe some, you know, long, some swearing of blood oaths and whatnot, but there was none of that. I think learning that I could do a whole bunch of things which I had no idea or even conceived of doing, you know what I mean? How many times would I have thought about jumping into Darling Harbour? No, it's dressed as the Red Baron. It's badass. I got to face a lot of things that I didn't think that I'd ever face before, and I can now cross off my list, so I think that was the best thing.
Cool. So you said about keeping in touch with the other people involved in the show. While it was being shown on television, you actually got together with the other contestants from Adelaide a bit to watch it.
What was that like,
particularly, you know, the first week, as you said, it was you and Stu against one another for the elimination, and so you would have both been
there
in the same
tension space
with his friends and your friends, and
there was some booing going on when Stu and I went head to head. It was pretty epic. I think they were all very, very tense. You could cut it with a knife. Everyone was just on the edge of their seats, and then I came through. I didn't feel good about winning, quite frankly. Mm-hmm. I felt good that I got to stay in, but I was just like, man, I sent this guy home.
Yeah.
And clearly he needed a shave. Now he's not going to get his shave. And he's, you know, because I think Stu really would have liked to have been there for the makeover. Mm-hmm. So that's what I felt bad about.
But, I mean, you continued on. It's not like you got out the next week and you have to feel bad about, you know, maybe he could have got further than you or something.
That's,
I mean,
true.
You did pretty well. You got to the final three. So
yeah, that was pretty awesome to do. Yeah, I had no idea that I'd do it every single week after the first week. Because that first week being nominated really hit home. That it's like, wow, I can go at any time. Better, you know, get my ass into gear and just get on to these challenges. And so I think that actually spurred me to give it my all.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, and that helped. But it was terrifying every week, just standing there on that staircase. You have no idea. It was nerve-wracking every week that I didn't win. I was thinking, I'm going to be put up. So, yeah.
And being in the final three, you got to have a wedding.
Yep, it was beautiful.
How was that? Like, I mean, what was it like? I mean, obviously you were going to come out of it. You weren't actually going to be married. But
I thought I was. I thought I was. I honestly thought I'm going to have to figure out what the law is on, you know, divorce and possibly an annulment.
I'm pretty sure you have to put in an intent to marry before you get married.
Yeah, so. I probably should know that since I'm a lawyer. But they never mentioned commitment ceremony. They said it was going to be done by a real, you know, person. I'm thinking, is this going to end with, is the next challenge going to be a divorce? What's going to happen here?
So do you have any advice for any, I suppose specifically geeks, but really anyone who's thinking of auditioning for the third season of Beauty and the Geek?
Don't do it. Don't do it, man. It's not worth it. What can I say? I'd say bring your best, geekiest self. To those of you who are thinking, oh, I can fake my way through it. No, they're very accomplished at spotting people who aren't really, really geeky. So it has to come from a place of honesty. But I know that since there are so many people who can geek out about a lot of things, you just have to, I guess, if you're antisocial to society in general, but hang out with your mates and discuss, you know, Magic the Gathering, Dungeons and Dragons, or any White Wolf games or anything like that, then that's a good sign. If you obsess over Doctor Who and have at any point in your life dressed as the Doctor, then that's a good sign.
I fear that I fit into several of these categories.
Yeah, well, you know.
Do you think they'll do a female, a male-female, switched around the opposite
direction? I hope so. I think that would be fun, you know, but I think they already cover that with Tool Academy. But, you know, male, I think the dynamic would be really different because male beauties are kind of dicks. Like, that's not true across the board, of course. I've met some really lovely, lovely guys who, you know, who probably would fit that definition of beauty. But male beauties have a different kind of skill set.
Mm.
You know, they are more, a lot of the challenges wouldn't work. It'd have to be completely switched around. You know what I mean? Because male beauties wouldn't have any problem touching bugs.
Yep.
Male beauties wouldn't have any problem probably building stuff and putting stuff together. I guess the concept beauty is, in Western society anyway, more closely associated with the idea of, like, female Barbie dolls, really. Not that any of the girls on the show really fit that stereotype, except maybe Tamika. But you know, but even she was, like, yeah, incredibly nice and... All the girls are nice, really. I have to keep saying that because everyone I talk to says that it's like, man, those girls, what's with them, man? Are they really that dumb? And I have to keep, you know, what do you say to that? It's like, well, you know, if you were interviewed for hours and then they cut 20 seconds out of it, how smart would you sound?
A lot can be done with editing.
Yeah.
Can you do some impersonations of some of your fellow contestants?
I can. The one that I'd always do would be George, because he has such a distinctive voice. So, you know, I'd come into his room and be like, "Good day, how you going? This claw we got here is from an Australian dinosaur, Australovenator wintonensis, and we found it right here in Winton. That's the way. That's so, and then Thomas's is a bit more difficult, but I think what you've got to do is you've got to speak really fast and don't really get your words out. Kind of you're a bit nervous, and you just have to talk about stuff like my Hawaiian t-shirt collection. I have so many Hawaiian t-shirts. It's amazing.
Well, thank you very much for talking to us, and I hope you have fun now that you're back in the real world.
Thank you.